Good morning, student. Today I am going to teach you chapter 3, noun. First of all, I will explain parts of a speech. Do you know what is parts of a speech? All words are placed in classes or categories called parts of a speech. Or, parts of a speech are the basic type of words that English has. There are 8 parts of a speech. Noun, adjective, pronoun, verb, adverb, preposition, conjunction and interjunction. Today we shall concentrate on noun. Noun, a noun is a name of a person, place, animal or thing. It may also name a feeling or idea. You can say that noun is the naming words in simple way. For example, Ram, Patna, box, etc. Kinds of noun. There are 4 kinds of noun. Proper noun, common noun, abstract noun and collective noun. Number 1. Proper noun. A proper noun which name a particular person, place or thing is called proper noun. Example. You can also say that proper noun is a special noun. Example. Boy. Ram. Boy, is it a common noun or proper noun? Which one is common, which one is proper? Boy is a common noun because we have not given a name. But if we have given a name of that boy, Ram, so Ram is a proper noun. Is it clear? Now next. Common noun. A noun that gives a common name to a person's, places or thing of the same kind is called a common noun. Example, teacher is teaching. Teacher is a common noun because we have not given any special name. And Sheetal is teaching, when we have given example, Sheetal is teaching, so Sheetal is a proper noun. Okay, now next, abstract noun. An abstract noun is the name of some state, quality, feeling or idea that we can only think or feel but cannot touch or see. Example, I like rainbow for its beauty. Can you touch beauty? No, you cannot touch beauty. So it is an abstract noun. And rainbow, you can see rainbow. So this is called noun. Okay, next, collective noun. A collective noun is the name of a collection of persons or things that taken together and spoken of as one whole. And you have all the collective noun is noun given to a group. See here. Here I have taken some examples from a book. That here a flower is there, a bouquet of flower, a bouquet of roses. So bouquet is a collective noun. A string of pearls. So a string is a collective noun. Here a group of keys. So we can say a bunch of keys. So bunch is a collective noun. When a noun stands for a collection of persons or things, it is called collective noun. Flock stands for a collection of sheep. Army stands for a collection of soldiers. Fleet stands for a collection of ships. Is it clear? Now herd of elephant, you can say we can write a herd of elephant. Next, abstract noun and concrete noun. Noun can also be classified as abstract or concrete. And you are clear about the abstract noun. Abstract nouns names feeling. Feeling means love, anger, sorrow. Qualities means bravery, honesty. These are abstract noun. State of mind, hope, trust or ideas, education, knowledge, no physical form that we may see or touch. These are abstract noun. Now concrete nouns. Concrete nouns stand for something that we can see or touch, something that has a physical form. So these are concrete nouns. And noun is also here. In your book, you have seen that noun is the. This is one more way of classifying nouns. Most common nouns are countable and they have both singular and plural forms, like wall. And other common nouns are uncountable. They have. Okay, so here we have. I have also written these things: walls, dog, dogs, bread, milk is a uncountable noun, which we cannot count. Okay, now this is your assignment for today. You have to complete your book, and if you have any problem, you can ask. These are questions from your book, Class 6.